Good to be with y'all here in Austin. I said y'all. I lived in Texas for two years, something like that, in Houston. It's a special place. And my oldest daughter, she looks at Texas in a very unique way because she was born there in Houston. She's never been. We moved to Nashville, Birmingham, now Memphis, and she really looks at this day. She's like she's gonna make a pilgrimage one day to visit the place of her birth. You know, and she holds it, man. Houston in particular. I'll introduce her to Austin. I'm sure she'll be thrilled with it. My wife and I, we have 5 children, and we are busy. Having a lot of fun and sort of in the whole world, balancing work and family. And in the middle of my wife's third pregnancy, our first son, I was reading something by Henry Nouwen. He was telling a story about 2 children, twins, in utero. And the first child says to the other, "I wonder if there's life after birth." That was absolutely brilliant. And it turned my head around in such a way. And that's where inspiration comes from, these little small things like this every now and again that will strike you. And I said, I'm going to write a song from the perspective of a child being born. And so I didn't have to look very far. I could just look to my side and see my wife and all that was going on with her. And anyway, out of that was born this song called This Colorful World. My world was closing in. I thought I'd take things out.
Oh.
out with Matthew and do things like we're doing this morning. And I spent a lot of my time in bars and clubs playing these songs, and sort of be in an environment like this that is where there's a foundation that exists for communication to happen is a real treat for me. And beyond that, Matthew has had a big impact on my life. He met me at a time shortly, right in the time period where I was getting dropped by my label and sort of reevaluating why am I doing music and art in the first place. And look at my children and my wife and ask, really, and these questions need to be asked and evaluated and reevaluated, but really, is this about my ego? Why am I doing what I'm doing? And, around 08, those questions remained unresolved, I think. And there was a number of other things that sort of crept in. In general, I felt a sense of disorder in the world. And in that, I found myself at Mass on Sunday morning in Mobile, Alabama, at Springfield College. And the priest was talking about the darkness that had to be present between Friday and Sunday. And he said something that stuck with me and that I held on to, and I know informed this song. And that was that a lot of times God does his greatest work in the midst of our darkness. And often in mountaintop experiences are important when we need them, but we also need to be grateful for those times when life and circumstance draws us again to our knees, because there's so much clarity that can be found there. And so I wrote this song out of one of those moments, and this is called Up From the Bottom. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
How are we all doing?